It's Christmas time.
Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. Merry Christmas. Now look, we started our first segment off with my brother, Reverend Nicholas Hood III, giving you the spiritual aspect of Christmas. And now I'm going to introduce you to the world's largest vegan, a 69-year-old of real stature that actually dyes his goatee. Ladies and gentlemen, Luther Big Lou Campbell. Lou, welcome to the show.
Clarification, you ever seen white dye? Now let's go on.
I've seen white dye, it's called bleach.
All right, bleach turns yellow on hair. Let's go on with the show.
Oh, you think it turns yellow, huh?
Let's go on with the show.
Okay, we'll put some Tide on there. You know, the last time you were here, all right, before we get into you helping us get through the whole Christmas eating and whatnot,
yes,
and getting prepared for summer, I want to go into your pedigree because we really didn't have enough time to do you justice. You just finished lecturing out in San Diego?
Well, I went on what we call a lecturing tour that I do every year.
Okay, tell us about that.
Some of the places that I have been, obviously Joe Paterno came up here before the crisis at Penn State, came up here with his coaching staff and asked me to come and lecture down at Penn State.
About the ills of pedophilia?
Well, no, that once again, that was prior to this situation here, that was several years ago. Mm-hmm. They go down to Penn State and lecture on the philosophy of winning, and his team, or members of his team, not all of them obviously, but had a problem with alcohol, and that was pervasive through the college campuses. So my lecturing for those 2 days were to demonstrate to the athletes and to the students how to eliminate that they didn't want to involve themselves in those type of activities.
Did their record improve after you?
Well, I can't say it's because of me, obviously, Steve. I'm only a minuscule part in what was happening at Penn State.
You're not minuscule in any measure.
A positive direction.
What are you, 6'9"?
Then also, I'm 6'6 at 285. Also at Tennessee State, I was down there with Jefferson Street Joe and Coach Joe Gilliam and Larry Tharp, who eventually played with the Detroit Lions. Mm-hmm. Columbia University with Jeff McCall. Florida A&M with Al Lawson, University of Michigan with countless athletes that I've had, and the list goes on. And
let's talk about some of the athletes that you've had.
Well, as I was sitting in the other room, I could not think of all of them. That's why I gave you the list in front of you. If you can go down the list, that would help me because once...
Okay, let's go. Carson Butler from Renaissance High School.
Carson.
He went on to U of M in the NFL.
Yes, he played with the New England Patriots. Matter of fact, in the last... preseason, he caught the only touchdown pass for Detroit Lions. When the Lions released him, he was picked up by the New England Patriots, and right now he's in negotiations with other teams.
Brian Westbrook,
first-round draft choice, Detroit Lions. They had a problem handling him, so the vice president of Lions, Larry Lee, who's a very dear friend of mine, called me in and asked me would I change his morality and his athletic education. And Detroit News fortunately did a very nice story on me and where I turned his career around, and he was on his way to make an All-Pro. He was a first-round draft choice, Detroit Lions.
Jalen Rose
out of Southwestern High School All-American. Obviously, everybody knows the story on Jalen Rose. He was with me for many, many years. Tremendous athlete, tremendous spokesperson. Went on to University of Michigan and played with four or five NBA teams, eventually signed for $100 million.
Anthony Adams
came to me at 14 years of age from Martin Luther King High School, went to Captain Penn State High School's, college team. They said he would never make it into the pros. His mother was persistent with him staying with me. We eventually got into his head, helped him with his speed. He became captain of the San Francisco 49ers. His number is 95, and now he's playing nose guard for the Chicago Bears.
Okay, one more, which is very interesting, and I watched you train this young lady, Yasha Moore.
Yasha Moore's a
dog. And it's different because you've been talking about football, you've been talking about basketball, but this young lady is in tennis.
Yes.
And you improved her forearm. Let's talk about that real quick.
Yasha Moore and Morgan, her teammate, out of West Bloomfield High School. Everybody should know her father, Larry Moore, former All-American high school basketball player out of Mumford High School. Played with Spencer Haywood at the University of Detroit. Went on to coach at West Bloomfield High School and Mumford High School. Well, Larry's like a brother to me. He brought me his daughter mm-hmm. over the last several years. We helped. She was very shy. We helped develop her. She later became an all-state tennis player. Mm-hmm. She matriculated at Wayne State University this past January, became Athlete of the Week at Wayne State University within 3 weeks after enrolling.
Okay. When we come back, we're going to talk about her forearm and a couple other things in terms of muscle development. Can you stick around?
I will.
Oh, I'm glad you can. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back with Big Lou, Steve Hood, and the goatee.
Come on, yo. It's Christmas time.
Facing a legal crisis? Then you need me, Ben Johnson. The courtroom is my office, and I'm out to win. I have the trial experience that matters. That's why I can take on the big guys and win. I've tried and won more jury verdicts than any other plaintiff attorney because I refuse to lose and I never back down. I'm Ben Johnson. I fight for your rights. Call me today.